Some days before I go to sleep, I replay all of my social interactions over in my head to make sure that I did them right. For example, my replay is telling me that that was disingenuous because it makes it sound like there are days when I don't do that, so let me try that again. Every day before I go to sleep, I replay all of my social interactions over in my head to make sure that I did them right. I am a ruthless critic. This was too forward. That was too coy. That was ill-timed. That was not funny. I'm looking for mistakes. Slip-ups. Evidence. Because I'm convinced that eventually everyone I know will decide that I am unworthy of companionship, and when they do, I want to know exactly why. What it was that gave me away would let them know that I am not, in fact, kind or funny or interesting, but just an awkward, unlovable mess. Of course, this is not true, but anxiety cares little for fact, it cares only for guilt. It doesn't remember your kind words, only that I stuttered in response. It only remembers laughter when it's cruel and smiles when they are not shared. My anxiety keeps lists of all the friends I have failed to make. It doesn't know the names of the ones that I have. Like a shoddy scientist, it dismisses all data that do not fit the theory. Anxiety dismisses a lot of data. And what it doesn't dismiss, it hoards. It whispers reminders of all the times I've slipped up, hoping to trip me again. Do you remember that time in fifth grade when Brian Johnson told you you had run well at the jogathon, and you just stared, saucer-eyed, until the bus rolled into school? You are still no better than that. Do you remember yesterday how you stumbled over your words to a customer again? Did you catch that nobody laughed at your joke? Anxiety cuts into my imperfections and blames me for bleeding. It is the most annoying older brother. Sitting on my back, asking me why I can't get up, taking my own limp hand to slap me with, "Stop hitting yourself, stop hitting yourself, stop hitting yourself." Except older brothers eventually grow out of it, and my anxiety just grows stronger. It has 25 years of arsenal to back it up. But so do I. And I am learning to fight back. Anxiety, I think your methods are flawed. Anxiety, I question your data. Anxiety, I do not think that this is a repeatable experiment. Some days, when I replay all of my social interactions over in my head to make sure that I did them right, anxiety is the better soldier, wielding awkward silences and terse smiles to cut through my compliments. Some days, anxiety wins, convinces me I am worthless and I don't deserve the friends I have. Some days, I go to bed defeated and alone, but not every day. Some days, I can skip my replay over my slip-ups and zoom in on connection. Some days, my mortified is not as strong as my blessed. Some days, I send anxiety to bed defeated and alone. Some days, I win. Not every day. But I will hoard my slim victories and pack them into cannonballs. I will write loved on every single one, so when anxiety comes around to whisper in my ear with its bloody knife of a tongue, I can open fire. Yeah.